Today, we're going to take a deep dive into your sense of touch. You might not always think of your skin as one big sensory organ, but sensing touch is one of its main functions. Your skin is full of a wide variety of sensory receptor cells that help you detect pressure, motion, vibration, temperature, and more. Your skin has three main layers. The epidermis is the protective outermost layer. It contains melanin, pigment that absorbs UV rays, keratin, a protein that protects the skin, and certain types of touch receptors. The dermis is the middle layer. It's composed of connective tissue rich in collagen and elastin, and contains hair follicles, sweat glands, and a whole bunch more touch receptors. The hypodermis is the deepest layer. It's composed mostly of connective tissue, and it serves as a buffer between muscle and skin, stores fat, and conserves body heat. Now let's focus on the various types of touch receptors, aka mechanoreceptors, in your skin. Merkel cells, located in the epidermis, sense intensity, detecting edges and points. They're particularly dense in the fingertips and the lips. Ruffini endings are also found in the epidermis. They sense skin stretch, joint activity, and temperature. This last one means that they're not only mechanoreceptors, but thermoreceptors too. Meissner's corpuscles are located primarily in the dermis, but they project up into the epidermis. These cells sense velocity, detecting skin motion. Pacinian corpuscles, which sense vibration, are found deep in the dermis. Your hair follicles contain receptors too, and these detect when hairs are moved. So what happens when one of these cells responds to a stimulus? Ion channels in the membranes of these cells open up, generating electrical signals. Different ion channels respond to different types of stimuli, like different temperatures and types of pressure or movement. The electrical signal from the receptor gets passed on to neurons, which bring that signal to the spinal cord and then on to the somatosensory cortex of the brain. In the case of somatic reflexes, like pulling your hand away from a hot surface to avoid being burned, the signal just needs to reach the spinal cord, and a motor response can be initiated without the need for processing in the brain. Want to learn more about the integumentary system and the nervous system? Visible Body Suite has all the 3D models and animations you need. Check it out at visiblebody.com/vbsuite.